Welcome to Learning English, a daily 30-minute program from the Voice of America. I'm Ashley Thompson.
And I'm Mario Ritter, Jr. This program is designed for English learners, so we speak a little slower and we use words and phrases especially written for people learning English.
On today's program, you will hear stories from Andrew Smith and Anna Mateo. Mario Ritter Jr. has this week's Health and Lifestyle Report. We close the show with another visit to a national park. We explore one of the least visited parks in America, Michigan's Isle Royale. But first,
the U.S. government plans to reduce the amount of Colorado River water several states are permitted to use next year. The river supplies water to 7 western states, more than 20 Native American tribes, and 2 states in Mexico. Those states and the country of Mexico are also considering plans for how to share the water after 2026. That is when many current rules and agreements about the use of Colorado River water will come to an end. The river brings water to millions of hectares of farmland in the American West. Hydroelectric dams on the river produce power. Experts say increased water use, combined with rising temperatures and dry weather, are the reasons for the need to make cuts. In 2007, following years of dry weather, the U.S. states in the river's basin and the federal government agreed to rules to help deal with lower water levels. The states involved were Arizona, Nevada, California, Colorado, New Mexico, Utah, and Wyoming. Those rules determine when some of the states must cut their water usage based on levels at Lake Mead. The lake is on the border of Nevada and Arizona. It provides water for hydropower, farming, and other needs. Because of the need for new rules, states, Native American tribes, and others are forming new plans to deal with even deeper water cuts that might happen in 2026.
The federal government will announce water cuts for 2025 based on levels at Lake Mead. If Lake Mead drops below a level that has been agreed to, Arizona, California, Nevada, and Mexico will face cuts. However, California might not face cuts because the current rules give that state special water rights. Last year, Arizona, California, and Nevada agreed to save an extra 3 million acre-feet of water in addition to the cuts the federal government had already required. An acre-foot is equal to about 1.2 million liters. In return, the U.S. government agreed to pay water districts and other users for much of that reduction in water use. Colorado, New Mexico, Utah, and Wyoming are in the river's upper basin. Those states have not used all of the water the rules permit them to use. For this reason, they have not yet had to reduce the amount of water they take from the river. Wet weather in 2023 and efforts to save water by lower basin states have increased the level of Lake Mead and Lake Powell. Lake Powell in Utah is another body of water that holds and releases water from the river.
However, experts say higher temperatures will continue to reduce water in the Colorado River in the coming years. In March, upper and lower basin states, tribes, and environmental groups proposed plans to deal with likely water reductions in the future. Arizona, California, and Nevada asked the federal government to include water levels at other reservoirs besides Lake Mead and Lake Powell. Their plan says that if the whole system drops below 38% of the maximum amount of water it can hold, the upper basin and Mexico should share deeper cuts equally with the lower basin. Colorado, New Mexico, Utah, and Wyoming want larger and sooner cuts when water is low at Lake Mead and Lake Powell. The cuts would affect California, Arizona, and Nevada. Their plan does not call for reductions in how much water upper basin states use. The federal government is expected to propose new rules by December. The rules would consider the different plans and possible steps for the future. Until then, states, tribes, and other groups will continue negotiations on water. I'm Andrew Smith.
And I'm Anna Mateo.
The World Health Organization is calling for donations to fight the latest outbreak of the viral disease Mpox in Africa. The UN Health Agency declared Mpox in Africa a public health emergency of international concern last week. The Director General of the WHO, Tedros Adhanom Ghebreyesus, made the announcement after a meeting of the WHO's Emergency Committee. The move follows a declaration by the Africa Centers for Disease Control and Prevention, or Africa CDC. That organization declared Mpox a public health emergency in Africa one day earlier. The WHO said there have been more than 14,000 cases and more than 524 deaths in Africa this year. So far, about 96% of all cases and deaths have taken place in one country, the Democratic Republic of the Congo. But the WHO and others are concerned that a new version of the viral disease could spread more easily among people. The Associated Press recently reported some of the information known about the current Mpox outbreak. Mpox is also known as monkeypox. The United States Centers for Disease Control and Prevention says the viral disease was first identified by scientists in 1958, when outbreaks of a pox-like disease appeared in monkeys. Until recently, most human cases involved people in Central and West Africa who had contact with infected animals. In 2022, experts confirmed that the virus could be spread through sex. Outbreaks were reported in more than 70 countries, that had not reported the disease before. Mpox belongs to the same virus family as smallpox. It causes symptoms like high body temperature, chills, and body pain. People with serious cases can develop lesions on the face, hands, chest, and sex organs. The number of cases has increased sharply in the last few weeks. The Africa CDC said the disease has been identified in at least 13 African countries. Compared to the same period last year, the agency said cases have increased by 160% and deaths by 19%. The version of Mpox seen in the Democratic Republic of the Congo could kill up to 10% of people infected. Unlike earlier Mpox outbreaks, where lesions were mostly seen on the chest, hands, and feet, the new form of Mpox causes less severe symptoms. This could make the disease harder to identify. The WHO said Mpox was recently reported for the first time in 4 East African countries: Burundi, Kenya, Rwanda, and Uganda. All of those cases were linked to the Democratic Republic of the Congo. In the Ivory Coast and South Africa, health officials have reported a less dangerous version of Mpox than the one that spread in 2022. The WHO's emergency declaration is meant to get donors to provide money for a campaign against the disease. African CDC Director General Dr. Jean Kaseya said the agency's declaration of a public emergency was meant to mobilize our institutions, our collective will, and our resources. Michael Marks teaches medicine at the London School of Hygiene and Tropical Medicine. He said, "It is clear that current control strategies aren't working, and there is a clear need for more resources." Most of the cases during the 2022 outbreak of the viral disease were gay and bisexual men. The virus was spread through close contact and sex. Although similar things are happening in Africa, children under the age of 15 now make up more than 70% of Mpox cases and 85% of deaths in the Democratic Republic of the Congo. WHO Chief Tedros said officials are dealing with several outbreaks and what he called different modes of transmission and different levels of risk. Greg Ram is with the aid group Save the Children. He said his organization is worried about Mpox spreading in crowded refugee camps. He said there were 345,000 children living in unhealthy conditions in the Eastern Democratic Republic of the Congo. Ram added that the country's health system is already collapsing because of malnutrition, measles, and cholera. Dr. Boguma Titanji is an infectious disease expert at Emory University in the American state of Georgia. She said, "It is unclear why the disease is mostly affecting children in the Democratic Republic of the Congo. She said children might become infected more easily, or social conditions like overcrowding or infected parents might explain the problem. The AP says in 2022, developed countries stopped the outbreak of Mpox with treatments and vaccines, but few vaccines are available in Africa. Marx said the immunization would likely help, including vaccination against the similar smallpox virus. He said, "We need a large supply of vaccine so that we can vaccinate populations most at risk." He said, "That would mean vaccinating children, sex workers, and adults in affected areas." The WHO has already released $1.45 million of emergency money for smallpox. But the UN agency says $15 million is needed to start efforts to combat the disease. I'm Mario Ritter, Jr.
Mario Ritter, Jr. joins me now to talk more about today's health report. Welcome, Mario.
Thank you, Ashley. It's nice to be here today.
The World Health Organization declared the recent outbreak of Mpox in Africa a public health emergency of international concern last week. The UN agency has called for donations to fight the outbreak, which is hitting Africa hard, especially the Democratic Republic of the Congo. I would like to talk about a vocabulary word that is central to today's report, the word pox. Can you explain for our listeners what that word means and how it is used?
Yes, sure, Ashley. Pox are spots on the skin that result from a skin infection. The word pox appears in the description of many infectious diseases. For example, there are smallpox, chickenpox, cowpox. Mpox was once known as monkeypox, but it is lately being called Mpox. Our report today says the virus that causes Mpox is related to the virus that causes smallpox. But the word pox describes the symptom, the effect of the disease. Doctors often call such skin infections lesions, which might be a little difficult to pronounce. Lesion is a medical term. But the word pox has been in the English language for a long time.
So, in the play Romeo and Juliet, Mercutio says a pox on both your houses when he is given a deadly wound by accident during a fight between two warring families. Is that right?
You know your Shakespeare, Ashley. And the singular of pox is pock. It gives us the word pockmark, which can describe a small scar or an area lower than the surrounding surface.
So the word pox has a long history in everyday language and even literature, while the word lesion, which also appears in this report, is used mainly in medicine. Is that correct, Mario?
I think so, Ashley. Both words are in the report and are heard together in writing related to certain diseases that affect human health.
All right. Well, thanks for that report and thank you for those explanations.
You're welcome, Ashley. Thanks for chatting with me today.
VOA Learning English has launched a new program for children. It is called Let's Learn English with Anna. The new course aims to teach children American English through asking and answering questions and experiencing fun situations. For more information, visit our website, learningenglish.voanews.com. On our national parks journey, we explore a remote island near Michigan's border with Canada. It sits within a huge freshwater lake. It is one of the least visited national parks in America. Welcome to Isle Royal National Park. Isle Royal is surrounded by the deep blue waters of Lake Superior, the largest freshwater lake on Earth by area. The park's quiet forests and rocky shores offer a kind of solitude and peace not found in some of the more popular national parks. No cars or other wheeled vehicles are permitted on Isle Royal. There are no real roads on the island. The only way to get to the park is by boat or seaplane. The National Park Service operates shuttle boats that take visitors to Isle Royal. The boats leave from two Michigan ports. The journey to Isle Royal takes 3 to 5 hours. Waters are often extremely rough.
Isle Royal is the largest of the islands within the national park. It is 72 kilometers long. The entire national park protects a total area of 230,000 hectares, including some 450 islands that surround Isle Royal. 52,000 hectares is land. The rest is water. Isle Royal became a national park in 1940. In 1980, officials named it an International Biosphere Reserve because of its unique ecosystem. Its remote location is part of what makes it among the least visited national parks. But once they arrive, most visitors stay a while. The average stay for visitors to Isle Royal National Park is 3.5 days. The average stay for visitors to most other national parks is just 4 hours.
Isle Royal offers hiking, camping, boating, and even scuba diving. The extremely cold waters of Lake Superior help keep shipwrecks in excellent condition. The National Park Service protects 11 sunken boats for divers to explore. They are reminders of Lake Superior's commercial shipping history. The sunken wooden ship called the America is one of the most popular dive sites. The America carried passengers, mail, and supplies to many towns along the shores of Lake Superior. It first launched in 1898, and was used until 1928, when it was damaged. It sank to the bottom of the lake soon after. Today, divers can swim through the ship's ballroom, bedrooms, and engine room. Painted on the ship's engine is an American flag. Many divers take pictures of this site.
The Rock Harbor Lighthouse is another reminder of the area's commercial history. Workers built the lighthouse in the 1850s to help guide ships safely to the island's copper mines. The mining industry was short-lived, however. The lighthouse itself lit the way for ships for just 24 years. But it still stands today. Inside, exhibits and information help visitors understand Isle Royale's maritime history. A short hiking trail leads visitors to the lighthouse. Visitors to Isle Royale share the trails with a well-studied population of moose and wolves. Both species migrated to the island sometime in the early to mid-1900s. Scientists believe that moose swam to the island. They think wolves walked there during a freeze of the lake sometime in the 1940s. Scientists have closely studied the relationship between Isle Royale's wolves and moose since the late 1950s. It is one of the best studied predatory-prey relationships in the world. Researchers closely record their population numbers. Much of the research takes place during the winter, when the trees are bare. The researchers fly over the island to observe the animals from above.
Animal research is the only winter activity going on at Isle Royale. The national park is closed each year beginning in late October because of the harsh weather conditions. It reopens in springtime the next year. But for the other months of the year, Isle Royale offers refreshing lake breezes, green forests, and clear blue waters. Its stunning scenery and unusual solitude keep visitors returning year after year. I'm Ashley Thompson.
And I'm Katie Weaver.
And that's our program for today. Join us again tomorrow to keep learning English through stories from around the world. I'm Ashley Thompson.
And I'm Mario Ritter Jr.